Everything that has transpired has done so according to my design.
This is not a race to the finish, but to those that endure, you know? And I got 10 Star Wars commandments that I want to bring to you guys.
Roger, see, Roger.
Been in this game for years. Mm-hmm. Made me an animal. It rules to this shit. I wrote me a manual, a step-by-step booklet for you to get your Star Wars back and not that other crap. Rule number one, Kathleen Kennedy, she's scum. Always call our ass out until she's done. Let Bob Iger know we ain't having no fun behind a feminist agenda that's so dumb. Rule number two, Ryan Johnson, dude. That beta male cuck is a part of this too. He thinks he's so cool with the shit he do, but little do he know we control hard too. Number three, Jar Jar Abrams, baby. Episode 4 reboot, we gave you a pass. Episode 9, now we gonna stay on your ass over that foul shit that showed you had no class. Number 4, know you heard this before. We're not real fans, cause we don't understand. Number 5, don't give a fuck, cause you know what's up. You better ram it down their throats, Last Jedi sucks. Number 6, the boycott is on, stay strong. We know what we're doing and we know we belong. 7, this rule is so underrated. Always on plot holes to keep this movie hated. You already know that they can't stand that. They'll cry, bitch, and moan, and we state in the facts. Number 8, never keep that hate on you. Pass it over to those bitches and take them to school. Number 9 should have been number 1 to me. Better love George Lucas for all eternity. Without the maker, we would have none of this. The greatest franchise that gave us all bliss. Number 10, a strong word called loyalty. For the OT and the PT. Do you want ST? You better say hell no. The Force Awakens and the Last Jedi blows. Follow these rules, Star Wars will come back. The EU is canon, rely on that. Don't need the ST that can't respect that. Our heroes getting butchered and there's no going back. We supposed to like the stories that fail every day. And on top of all of that, you want us to pay? You be smoking that good shit, I have to say. The best thing to do is to stay the hell out our way.
The Force is strong with you.
Attack of the Clones, Episode 2. Padme Amidala now travels through. Coruscant to vote on something large. The actor will put the military in charge. She got ambushed in broad daylight. Chancellor asked the Jedi protect the life. They called in Anakin and Obi-Wan to look over her till the threat was gone. 10 years passed, Anakin still in love with the woman of his dreams from heaven above. But the would-be assassins tried again, they failed, and now the mystery begins. The Jedi Council said enough is enough. Obi-Wan, go to Kamino, see what's up. Anakin, head to Naboo with Padme and make sure that no harm comes her way. Obi-Wan was shocked by what he just saw. A full-fledged army prepared for war. They're clones of the bounty hunter Jango Fett. Darth Tyrannus hired them for the project. Anakin and Padme profess their love, but they couldn't act on it, and that's because they're from two different worlds that should not collide. It was tearing them both up from the inside. That night, Anakin really had a dream. He packed up and headed straight to Tatooine. His mother was kidnapped, he feared the worst. When she died in his arms, he had the thirst of the rage and the anger he kept at bay. He killed every sand person in his way. He made another promise in front of a grave that he will stay strong till his dying day. Count Dooku told Obi-Wan Sith back, they need to band together to counterattack. Obi-Wan said, no, you must let me go. Count Dooku said, no, you're the star of the show. Anakin and Padme tried to rescue him, but they both were captured. Let the games begin. Palpatine said the Separatists was ready for war. Let's give them exactly what they bargained for. Mace Windu said, I'll go take the Jedi to rescue Obi-Wan before he died. Yoda said, I'll head out to see the clone, to see what kind of skills that they all now own. Mace Windu came out hard with the whole squad, killed Jango Fett, but they're stuck in the yard. Count Dooku said, I'm sorry, but you all must die. Then Yoda and the clones came from out the sky. The Clone Wars began, all hell broke loose. Jedi was fighting for the justice and truth. The Geonosians had a wicked plan that must not fall in the hands of man. He would give it to his master. Then they ruled the galaxy, then the hereafter. Anakin and Obi-Wan caught up to him, but Count Dooku was too strong for them. He was about to kill him when Yoda arrived. He handled Dooku quick, so he had to fly. The fighting was over, but the war began. Dooku showed Darth Sidious the plans. Anakin and Padme got married on Naboo. It was still a secret, so nobody knew. Yoda knew the dark side was involved, but that's another problem that they must solve. So holla back.
Prepare to fire.
Do you remember Phasma? You know, that's okay. Rose Tico saved animals, but not the slaves. We said that Finn had no arc every day. But guess what? True Freedom's ass here today. But after all that, he now knows the Force. After chasing Rey all this time? But of course, he doing interviews, said the Last Jedi trash. Took him 2 years, but that shit was still cash. Daisy Ridley says she's done with this shit. Blame Ryan for making her a super bitch. But that didn't stop her in episode 9. She was doing shit that can't fucking be defined. Shooting Sith lightning through her fingertips. Without no training, yeah, you know that's bullshit. Even your boy Kylo said, what the fuck is this? They give me none of that in the script. Speaking of the emo one, let us begin. His fetish for Rey made him turn back to Ben. Papa Palpatine had a stick up his ass. Snoke was a clone, that shit made me laugh. General Hux was my dude to the core. In The Force Awakens, he was ready for war. Last Jedi, he was straight kissing the floor. He became Kylo Ren's bottom bit to shore. Rise of Skywalker, now he's a spy. They caught him and they shot him. Did he live? No, he died. What you know about that? Teach you the fact. How to put Star Wars right back on the map. The EU is canon, don't care what they say. The trilogy is dead, so send it on its way. J.J. Abrams should have known when to quit. Pablo Hidalgo, yeah, don't have a fit. You blocking everybody, but no one gives a shit. Chuck Wendig is still unemployed snitch. He's still writing books, but no one's reading it. And Freddie Prinze Jr., straight clown that he is, still yelling out Star Wars is only for kids.
Star Wars is for fucking kids.
You will find that it is you who are mistaken about a great many things.
You're a feisty little one. But you'll soon learn some respect.
If the Star Wars super fans, you understand, and you know that we're backed by popular demand. So together we stand, divided we fall. If you hate what they did, then you must heed the call. Get your backs off the wall, it's a door for you. And if you know what I know, join the Phantom Menace crew. We're the best in the West, not the least in the East. From the North to the South, you will taste defeat. Don't be scared, we're getting you the fuck out of here. Cause you disrespect the franchise that was so revered by the fans who love the cosplay every time. Who stood on long lines to see our heroes shine. Who reads all the books and buys all the toys. Who taught their own kids of the things we enjoy. There's no other franchise like Star Wars, brethren. Han, Luke, Leia, and Lando are a legend. Not to be changed in any part of the game. What the hell's wrong with you? Have you gone insane? Yes, indeed. That's why you'll never succeed. We're keeping our money, bring Disney to its knees. We want a great stories without the agenda. We want all the wonderful things that we remember in our youth. That's why Star Wars is the truth. Until we get it back, it's time to raise the roof, no doubt. That's why I'm running up my mouth on YouTube and everywhere else, cause I'm about respecting the vision of the maker GL, respecting the work and the things he excels, respecting the story he wants us to see, respecting the lore and the mythology. I'm here to see fake Lucasfilm burn down and all them other clowns getting ran out of town. They didn't understand how deep this thing was and what we're gonna do for the thing that we love and what we'll protect with our last dying breath to show these shills the true meaning of respect.
Please like, subscribe, and comment on the video. May the Force be with you.